guys, it's Deaton here. Are y'all ready to dance? I hope so. We're going to do the jump dance. So we've done this before. Hopefully it's a review and hope you have fun.
Yo. Come on, let's go. Put your right leg to the side.
Now jump.
Put your left leg to the side.
Now jump.
Cross your arms, do a real tie.
Now jump.
Put your arms up real high.
Now jump.
Put your right leg to the side.
Now jump.
Put your left leg to the side.
Now jump.
Cross your arms, do a real tie.
Now jump.
Put your arms up real high.
Now
come on,
jump.
Now just roll to the front. Roll to the front. Roll to the front. Roll to the front. Now roll to the back. Roll to the back. Roll to the back. Roll to the back. Put your right hand out, your left hand out. Flip the right hand. Now let's begin with the pancake. Do the pancake. Do the pancake. Do the pancake. Now do the rollerblade. Do the rollerblade. Do the rollerblade. Do the rollerblade. Let me see you snake with it. Just snake with it. Just snake with it. Just snake with it. Make your legs shake with it. Make them shake with it. Make them shake with it. Make them shake with it. Now just wave with it.
Come on.
Just wave with it.
Come on.
Just wave with it.
Come on.
Come on. Now let's go. Put your right leg to the side.
Now jump.
Put your left leg to the side.
Now jump.
Cross your arms, do a real tie.
Now jump.
Put your arms up real high.
Come on.
Put your right leg to the side.
Now jump.
Put your left leg to the side.
Now jump.
Cross your arms, do a real tie.
Now jump.
Put your arms up real high.
One more time.
Just roll to the front. Roll to the front. Roll to the front. Roll to the front. Now roll to the back. Roll to the back. Roll to the back. Roll to the back. Put your right hand out. Your left hand out. The right hand. Now we begin with the pancake. Do the pancake. Do the pancake. Do the pancake. Now let me roll a blade. Do the roller blade. Do the roller blade. Do the roller blade. Now just snake with it. Just snake with it. Just snake with it. Just snake with it. Let your legs shake with it. Let them shake with it. Let them shake with it. Let them shake with it. Now just wave. Come on, wave.
Come on.
Just wave. Come on, wave. Let's go. Put your right leg to the side.
Now jump.
Put your left leg to the side.
Now jump.
Cross your arms, do a real tie.
Now jump.
Put your arms up real high.
Come on, jump.
Put your right leg to the side.
Now jump.
Put your left leg to the side.
Now jump.
Cross your arms, do a real tie.
Now jump.
Put your arms up real high.
Now jump.
Let's go. Another Zonda Flex production coming at you.
All right, good job. I hope you had fun. That is the jump dance. All right, for this movement exploration activity, you are going to be playing the part of the monkey. Okay, there's no sounds except for the narrator in this story. So I'm going to be the narrator and I will explain what the monkey is doing and you're going to act it out with your body. So it's just like the star dance where you just listen and do what it says with your body movements, except this time you're going to be a monkey. Okay, and your whole body is the monkey, so not just your hands or anything. You want to act it all out with your body. So use your imagination, have fun with it, and really pretend you're in this environment that I describe in the story. Okay, so let's do it. This is the monkey and the dots. This is the story of a monkey who lived in the jungle. The monkey loved swinging from tree to tree. One day, as the monkey was swinging along through the jungle, it looked down and saw something unusual on the floor of the jungle. So it jumped down to take a closer look. There, right in the middle of the jungle, was a big silver box with a lid on it. The monkey had never seen a box before, so it tiptoed carefully around the box, very confused, trying to figure out what it was. The monkey then decided to try to open the box to see what was inside. The lid was very heavy, though, so the monkey had to use all its muscles to get it open. Let's count to three and then try to lift the lid. One, two, three. Lift! But it wouldn't open, so the monkey tried again. One, two, three. Lift! But the lid still wouldn't open. So the monkey tried one more time. One, two, three. Lift! And popped open, and the monkey stared into the box. It was full of little dots. Red dots and blue dots, green dots and purple dots. The monkey reached into the box and put one dot into its hand. The monkey moved its hand around slowly, staring at the dot. and then suddenly the dot jumped off the monkey's hand and landed on its foot. The monkey began to hop along, staring at the dot on its foot. Then the dot jumped off the monkey's foot and landed on its elbow. The monkey began to slide sideways, looking right at the dot on its elbow. Next, that crazy dot jumped right onto the monkey's back. The monkey twisted and turned, trying to see the dot on its back. Oh my goodness, the dot jumped off the monkey's back and began flying through the air all around the jungle. And the monkey chased it left and right, up and down. And finally, the monkey jumped into the air and grabbed the dot. But when the monkey opened its hand, there were not one, but two dots inside. The monkey began to juggle the two dots like a circus juggler. The monkey then looked up to see that all the dots were now jumping out of the box. There were hundreds of colored dots flying through the air. The monkey began to dance and spin and leap and jump and roll as it tried to see all the dots. Then the monkey heard a noise. Oh dear, someone is coming. I'd better put all these dots back in their box. So the monkey carefully picked all the dots out of the air, off the trees, off the ground, and put them back in the box where they belonged. Then the monkey closed the lid with a bang and went swinging away through the trees again. Then the monkey curled up in a tree and fell fast asleep. This song is called What a Wonderful World, and it is sung by Louis Armstrong. It was written by George David Weiss and Bob Thiel, and the book is illustrated by Ashley Bryan.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do. They're really saying I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Don't y'all love that song? That's one of the most soothing songs for me. I love his voice. It's so unique, and I just love that song. It's such a good message. So I'm going to teach it to you now, and I'm going to teach you a simplified version. It cuts out a couple parts, so that way it's easier to remember the words. So I'm going to teach you some motions that go with it to help you remember the words as well. So at the beginning, it says, I see trees of green, red roses too. Okay, so it goes, I see trees of green, red roses too, red roses too. And so for the motions, you're going to, your right hand's going to go across and you're going to sweep across. So it goes, I see trees of green, other hand, red roses too. And then you're going to put your hands like this. I see them bloom. What is bloom? Have you ever seen a flower bloom? Remember, a flower opens up. So, I see them bloom for me and you. I see them bloom for me and you. So first, what does it say? I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. Okay, so let's do that together. Ready, set, go. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. All right? So then after that, you're going to point to your head and you're going to sing, and I think to myself. So point to your head and then point to yourself, okay? And I think to myself. And then put your hands up like, what? What a three. And you're going to do a W, world. You're going to circle your hands and then end with them on top of each other like that. Okay, so it goes, what a wonderful world. Okay, so it goes at the end, it's, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Okay, all right, so let's put that all together. It's a lot of words. So it's trees of green, red roses too, I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Okay? It's definitely beginning. One, two, ready, go. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Okay, so that's the first part. Then you're gonna add the second half, and it goes, you're gonna go up with your hands, because we're talking about skies of blue. So it goes up, instead of in front like this, we're gonna go up. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. So what two things did we see? Skies of blue, clouds of white. All right, so sing that with me. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. Yes, and then you're gonna put your hands above you like this, okay, like a circle, or a half circle, and you're gonna sing the bright, blessed day. The bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. So those two things, it's the bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. Bright, blessed day, dark, sacred night. Say that with me. Bright, blessed day, dark, sacred night. Night. Those are the hardest words to remember of the song. Okay. Bright, blessed day, dark, sacred night. Okay. All right. So put that together. So we have skies of blue, clouds of white, bright, blessed day, dark, sacred night. Okay, so let's do that. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. And the next, the rest of it's easy because we already did it. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Then you're going to repeat that last part and you're going to say, yes, I think to myself, slowly. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Right? So, that last half. Skies of blue, clouds of white, bright blessed day, dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. And you repeat it. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Okay? And that's it. So that's a simplified version of the song. Now let's do the whole thing. Okay, so the whole thing. So we're starting with trees of green, red roses too. Okay, all right. Let's do it. Ready, set, go. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Now we're going to do it the whole song with the music this time.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue. Dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful
goes. I hope you enjoy it. And that is What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. Well, it was sung by Louis Armstrong. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something new with it. So go sing that song to someone you know. Even if you don't know them, you can sing to them. Be pretty fun. All right. Bye, guys. Good job. All right, you ready to do Gorilla Man Ninja? Hope so. This time, it's you versus me, okay? So you keep track of the score. So just to remind you, we have Gorilla, Man, and Ninja. There are three options, okay? If you win, you get a point. If you lose, I get a point. Okay, so you keep track of the score. All right, so I'm going to turn to the side while I sing, and then I will turn to the front whenever it's time to put out what you're gonna be. Okay, that way you can still hear my voice. If I turn all the way around, you're probably not gonna be able to hear my voice. So let's do it. Ready? Let's do this song real quick, actually, first. Gorilla beats a man. Man beats a ninja. Ninja beats gorilla if you tie her up. Okay? All right, let's do it. Real game. First to three. Well, let's do best out of three. Best out of three. So if you win two, you win. Okay? All right. Ready, set, go. Gorilla beats a man. Man beats a ninja. Ninja beats gorilla if you tie her up. Okay, so who won? Think about the song. I'm ninja. Think about what you are and decide who wins. Okay, and give your point to either you or me. All right, let's do it again.
Ready, set, go. Gorilla beats a man. Man beats a ninja. Ninja beats gorilla if you tie her up.
Okay, what's your point? Either your point or my point. Just think about what you are. I'm man. Okay, let's do it again.
Ready, set, go. Gorilla beats a man. Man beats a ninja. Ninja beats gorilla if you tie her up.
All right, so think about who one, and it's best out of three. So if we tie, then neither of us got a point. So whoever has the most points wins at that point, okay? Now, if you want to, you can go play with somebody else as well. So, but it's a fun game. I hope you have fun with it. I just wanted to review it this week. I know we learned it last week and we went over it last week, but I just want to review it. So I hope you got it in your head now. That is Gorilla Man Ninja. All right, we're going to be talking about instruments today and their families. So do you remember the four instrument families we've focused on over the years? So here's a bunch of instruments, just random instruments. Can you remember the four families? Look at them and think about which family they're in. And it has to do with the way they're played. That's what makes it a family, is the similarity in how they're played and what they're made of a lot of the time. But so, what are instruments called that you hit, shake, scrape, or rub? What's that family? It's like drums, maracas, xylophones. What family is that? Do you remember? Percussion. That's right. So we got the percussion family. That's one. What about instruments that have strings on them? That's a pretty easy one. Instruments that have strings on them are in the string family. So that's two. So we have percussion and string. And then we have the two other families you use your mouth to play. And one you buzz with your mouth. One you buzz. The other one you blow or use a reed. So what do you remember those other two families? One starts with a B, one starts with a W. We got the brass. That's the ones you buzz. Like, well, I'm not going to give it away, but that's the buzzing ones. And then woodwind, the blowing ones. Think you blow wind. Okay. So those are our four families: percussion, string, brass, and woodwind. And so now we're going to check out which instruments are in which family. So in the percussion family, that is, those are instruments like drums, xylos or xylophones, a piano, auxiliary percussion. So like all the extra, the ones that make unique sounds, like this, all the drums are percussion. What makes a piano a percussion instrument? We've talked about that before. Because a lot of people says, well, it has strings inside of it, so it is string family, but it's not. And some people say, well, it's a percussion instrument because you hit the keys.
to play them. And I don't know about you, but whenever I'm playing piano, I'm not hitting the keys when I play. So it does not have to do with that. It is a percussion instrument because of what happens inside an acoustic piano whenever it's played. Have you ever looked inside and seen what happens to the strings? So whenever you press a key down. So whenever you press a key, the hammers in back behind inside the piano, the hammers hit the strings. And so that's the key word is hit. So because a percussion instrument is an instrument that is hit to make noise, to make the vibrations happen. And so a piano inside the hammers hit the string to create the vibration. So that's why a piano is in the percussion family. But all of these, so we have bongos, piano, xylophone that you play with mallets, a triangle that you play with a mallet, a snare drum that you play with drumsticks, maracas, tambourine, djembe. So, and these are just a few. There's a lot of percussion instruments. There's a lot, whole lot. So these are just a few of them. All right, so that's the percussion family. We have the string family. This one's easy because if it has strings, then it's a string instrument for the most part, except for what we just talked about, piano. So so the harp, how do you play a harp?
Excuse me.
How do you play a harp? You pluck the strings, right? So, and then for all four of these, what is this thing laying behind the violin? Do you know what that's called? It's the thing that you play it with. That is called a bow. Okay, so you use the bow to go across the strings and play. So we have a violin is the smallest, and then a little bigger than a violin. Do you know what that's called? A viola. Viola. So we have violin, viola. They both start with Vs. And then bigger than that, you have to sit down to play it, is a cello. That's why it has this thing. That's how you know it's a cello. You have to sit down to play it, and that keeps it still. And then you have the biggest one is the bass. The bass. And that you have to stand to play. So it's like violin, viola, you have to sit down, cello, and you have to stand up to play bass. So, and there's different kinds of bass. This is a string bass, so. There's a bass that's like a guitar, a long guitar. But so these are your orchestra, primary orchestra instruments, harp as well. And then you have right here, you have the guitar, just a regular guitar. And then what is a little guitar with only four strings called? Starts with a U. Ukulele. Okay, so that is a ukulele. We have guitar, and there's other string instruments too, but these are the main ones. Okay. So that's your string family. We have our brass family. If you notice, what they're made of is similar. So it looks like brass, kind of looks kind of golden. But what makes them brass instruments is how you play them. It's a circular mouthpiece that you buzz. You put the mouthpiece on your mouth, and then you buzz into it, creates vibrations, and then it goes through the horn and goes out the bell. But that's what makes it brass. So what is this one right here? This is the most common brass instrument. Most well-known, should I say? Not common, most well-known. Trumpet right here, trumpet. And then a long trumpet with a slide is called a trombone. So it's long, so it can go lower. So the longer something is, the tubing is, the lower it can go. So we have trumpet, trombone. Then we have this one that looks really long. If you unravel it or straighten out those tubes, it'd be really long. That is called a French horn. That is my favorite instrument to listen to, if it's played well. But that is a French horn that plays songs like Star Wars, famous for that. It has, because it's so long, it has such a big range. It can go really high and it can go really low. So that's what's cool about the French horn. So we have trumpet, trombone, French horn, and the biggest one is called the what? Tuba. And it's the lowest because it's so big. So it's the tuba. It's the lowest brass instrument. All right, so that's the brass family. And we have our woodwind family. These are the ones that you blow into or use a reed, which is a piece of wood, a special piece of wood, that you put in your mouth. And it's connected to the mouthpiece, which whenever you blow into it, it vibrates and goes into the instrument. So the only woodwind instrument that does not use a reed is flute, and then the baby flute, which is called a piccolo. So those two do not use reeds, but all the others do. So we have flute right here. Then we have, what is this? Do you know what this is? It's what Squidward plays. Clarinet. The clarinet. All right, so there's clarinet right there. This long one that looks a lot like a clarinet, but if you look at the top part, the mouthpiece, that looks different. This is called an oboe. Oboe. And so this one is a double reed, which is two reeds put together. And then whenever you blow into it, it creates vibrations in the middle, and then it goes through the horn. So this is a clarinet. It has one reed. It's a single reed. And an oboe is a double reed. Okay, then next, this one looks like it belongs in the brass family, doesn't it, with the color of it? But the mouthpiece is not circular. So that's how you know it's a reed instrument. It goes in your mouth, so you blow into it, which makes it a woodwind. All right, so this is a saxophone, and there's all different kinds of saxophones. There's all different sizes, alto, barry, tenor, soprano. There's all different. The smaller it is, or the smaller the tubing is, shorter the tubing is, the higher it's going to be. More tubing, the longer it is, the lower it's going to be. This is a bass clarinet, so it's like a low version of the regular clarinet. That's why it's so long. It's curved. It's so long. So it's going to be a low clarinet. And there's other ones. There's bassoon, there's piccolo, there's English horn. Those are all also in the woodwind family. Okay. Now we're going to practice listening and trying to identify the instrument by just listening to it. So let's do it. Now what I want you to do is to get a piece of paper and number it 1 through 11, or you can put it in this pattern. I'm going across the top row and the middle row and then the bottom row. But I'm going to play an instrument. I want you to write it down if you can identify what it is. Hopefully write it down before I say it, because I'm going to give you the answer for each one anyway, just so it's clear. I'm going to try to help you figure the answer out if you don't know it. So, but if you know it, write it down, and then we'll see how many you know at the end. Okay? So listen and try to guess which instrument it is. So what was that? Could you tell? It's one of the most common woodwind instruments. Hint, hint. That is a flute. Very good. That is a flute. Let's go on to the next one. All right, what is that? You should know that one. That is a piano. Piano. Very good. What about this one? So if you could tell by the sound of it, what's the only instrument that can slide like that? Ooh, kind of like a slide whistle. What's the only brass instrument that can slide? It's like a giant trumpet. The trombone. That is trombone. It can slide. All right, what about this one? All right. That is my favorite. Do you remember what it was? That's the French horn. And it is famous for Star Wars, which it just played. So, all right, what's next? What was that? What kind of instrument was that? Could you tell? Was it one that you blow, that you use your hands to play, that has something specific on it? I'm trying to give you hints without giving it away. So that is a string instrument. And did you notice it went pretty high at the end? The beginning you may not be able to tell, but towards the end it went pretty high. So that was a violin. All right, that was a violin. Let's keep going. All right. So that one, you can tell it's not played by the mouth, so it's either string or percussion. But just think about the feel of it. It sounded like it was hitting. What kind of instruments do you hit and use mallets with? Xylophone. There you go. Xylophone. So that is xylophone. What about this one? All right. So that one sounds like it's being plucked. It sounds angelic, very peaceful. So which instrument? That is the harp. And a lot of kids, for some reason, think it's heart, because some of them are actually shaped in the shape of half of a heart, but it is called a harp with a P, harp. All right, so last row. Let's see if we can get them. All right. So what do you think? It's in what family? Think about what family first. Are you using your mouth to play or using something else to play it? Did it go high or low? For some reason, the beginning of that one kind of gave it away. So it was very low at the beginning and it was a string. So it was a low string instrument. What is that called? You have to think about it because there's four string instruments. You have violin, viola, cello, and bass. So in that category, in that that would work with that sound. So think about it. I think it is cello. It is cello. It did end kind of high, but that's probably pretty high for a cello. So it started low. So that kind of gave it away, I think. All right. So what do you think did that one? That's pretty well-known brass instrument. That is the trumpet. Very good. All right. So there's the trumpet. We got two more. All right, that's a really low one. You could tell they were buzzing with the sound of it. So that kind of gave it away. So which family do you buzz in? You have to think about that. And then low, to be a low buzzing instrument, that would be tuba. That would be tuba. All right, last one. All right, so that was a unique sound. But what instrument was that? It sounded like someone was blowing into it. So that tells you it's either brass or woodwind. And what did it sound like? What do you think? Last one. Clarinet. Very good. Clarinet. So those are all the sounds. I hope you identified them. And you just have to think about how it sounds like it's being played. That's a big part of it. Not technically what it looks like, but how it's being played. So, but there's a lot of other instruments. That's just a few of them. We did 12 or 11. All right, now what I want you to do is to take a picture of your paper where you wrote down the instruments and attach it to your assignment, and that will be your product for the week. So don't forget at the end to put mark as done and turn in the attachment whenever you turn in the picture of your paper, okay? All right, but that's it. I hope you learned something today. That's my goal, and I hope you had fun. So, I'll see y'all next week. Bye, guys.